Good morning, students. Today we are going to see how to draw an electron dot structure of covalent compounds. Electron dot structure, which is also called Lewis dot structure. So let us see how can we draw structure of a covalent compound using this method. First, we can see for chlorine molecule Cl2. Chlorine, as we know, has 7 electrons in its valence shell. So, we'll be using 7 electrons. Since there are 2 chlorine atoms, 7 electrons for this chlorine atom also. Next, we are going to show the sharing part. Because we know each chlorine atom requires 1 electron to become stable, so they are going to share their electrons. Now these 2 electrons being shared is called shared pair of electrons. Now what happened? These 2 shared pair of electrons will be coming closer and will lie exactly in between the 2 chlorine atoms. Remaining electrons of each chlorine atom can be shown as it is, and it is these 2 shared pair of electrons that will form a covalent bond between chlorine atom, forming a chlorine molecule. So this we have for the chlorine molecule. Now suppose we want to show for oxygen, O2. As we know, oxygen has 6 electrons in its outermost shell or in its valence shell, and so they will gain 2 electrons. I mean, each oxygen atom is going to gain 2 electrons to complete its octet. So this is how we can show. Where you can see there are 2 shared pair of electrons, so we can again keep these shared pair of electrons close to oxygen atoms, and the other electrons can be shown as it is. That means this shared pair of electron is going to form double bond between oxygen molecule. Now we are going to see some covalent molecule where there are 2 different atoms present. Let us see. For example, HCl. As we know, hydrogen has 1 electrons and chlorine has 7 electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So it will gain 1 electron. At the same time, hydrogen also needs 1 electron to complete its duplet. But you can see, since chlorine is more electronegative in character than hydrogen, this shared pair of electrons should be shown more towards the chlorine atom. So this is how we can show now. This is more towards the chlorine atom, and it is this that forms the covalent bond between hydrogen and chlorine. I hope it is clear. Now let us discuss some important questions given in the exercise. First is question number टू एलिमेंट्स ए बी एंड सी हैव एटॉमिक नंबर्स 17, 19 एंड 10 रिस्पेक्टिवली. नाउ यू हैव टू स्टेट विच वन इज अ नॉन मेटल, मेटल एंड केमिकली इनर्ट एंड राइट डाउन द फॉर्मूला ऑफ द कंपाउंड फॉर्म बाय टू ऑफ द एबव एलिमेंट्स. दैट मीन्स फ्रॉम दिस The very first thing that you should do is to write the electronic configuration of each elements given using their atomic numbers. Like A, element A has atomic number 17, electronic configuration is 287. B is 19, electronic configuration 2881. And C is 10, it can be 28. Now you can see which one is a non-metal. So non-metal is B, metal is A, and chemically inert is element C. Second question is, write down the formula of the compound formed by two of the above elements. So here you can see the two elements A and B can only form compounds as they are chemically reactive because they have incomplete outermost shell. So this element C is not going to take part in the formation of compound as it is chemically inert. So when you use A and B, you know that B is a metal and will have a one positive charge and A will have one negative charge. So these two will combine together to form a compound BA. We have question number 11. Let us see how to do this. Question number 11 is, element X, Y, Z have atomic numbers 6, 9 and 12. X is 6, 2, 4, Y is 9, 2, 7 and Z is 12, 2, 8, 2. Which one forms anion? Anion. So anion will be formed, anion means negative charge, which will be formed only after gaining electron. So here you can see Y needs one electron to become stable or to complete its octet. So B will form negative charge, not B, Y. So anion is Y. Then cation, which can lose electron and can form positive charge, it will be Z. Now state type of bond between Y and Z and give its molecular formula. So type of bond between Y and Z, because Y is a non-metal, Z is a metal, so bond will be ionic bond. And formula we can write, since Z is a metal, metal should be written first with two positive charge and Y will have one negative charge. And the compound will be ZY2. This is the formula of the compound formed. We'll have one more question, last question, question number 16. Question number 16 is, element A has two electrons in its M shell and element B has atomic number 7. So we can write A since it has two electrons in its m shell, so we can complete the electrons this way, KLM. And B atomic number is 7, so we can write 2 and 5. We'll write 2 and 5. Write equation to show how and B form ions. Let us see. A will form ions after losing this valence electron to form A2 plus, and B requires 3 electrons to become stable, so it will be B3 minus. Next is, if B is a diatomic gas, write the equation for the direct combination of A and B to form a compound. So that means we have to now combine A and B, where B is a diatomic gas. So we can write B as B2, and then the compound will be by combination of A and B, but using the valency we can write A3B2. So this is the compound. I hope it is clear, and next class we will discuss on coordinate bond, a new type of bond. Thank you.